Is the screen share visible? Can I just acknowledge it in the chat box? Am I clearly audible? Okay. Now, this is what we had done last lecture, right? Since last two lectures, we are I am discussing with you all this formula. Cost plus profit is equal to sales. We discussed about direct cost. We discussed what are the features of a direct cost, that it should be variable in nature and it should depend on units produced. We discussed on indirect cost. It is opposite of direct cost. It is not variable, does not depend on units produced. Then we looked into the different types of direct cost, direct material, direct labor, direct expenses. And we looked into the different types of indirect cost, that is factory, admin, selling and distribution. Okay. And then we looked into their definitions as well. Let's say factory overheads means expenses paid by manufacturer till the factory gate. Admin overheads are expenses paid by manufacturer for better management or for upkeep of the office. That's a P&L account debit side. Then we also discussed about selling and distribution overheads. Okay. Selling and distribution overheads are expenses paid by manufacturer with respect to selling and distribution of finished goods. Okay. Somebody raised hand, Samruddhi. Yeah, there. Any problem? Post it in the chat box there. Samruddhi, you have raised hand. Is there any query? You can post it in the chat box. Okay. So today we are going to start with the format part. Now, whatever we have studied about direct cost and indirect cost, today we will see how we frame it in a statement. Okay, so when there is a cost audit, when the auditor comes for cost audit, he will check the statement which you are going to learn today. Okay, that is what they check when they do their cost audit. So, few seconds left, then I'll be locking the meeting room. And lock the meeting room. Now, let us understand what are we going to do today. Okay. We'll make a statement. We are doing cost sheet today, right? So, make the statement. Prepare it up to one and a half or 2 pages it will be. Lengthy format in the auditor. Okay. So you guys have to make 3 columns. First column should be wider. Next, 2 columns for amount. Let us start. So, right now, This is called a cost sheet. Right. Cost sheet means it helps us to calculate total cost price of a product. Cost sheet, it's a statement for the year ended. Whatever year is given in the question exercise. And this is your ESMA. Cost Accounting Standard 1. Okay. So now, units produced. That is the quantity. Next, units sold. Next, amount column, and the last column is cost per unit column. Okay, so it is units produced, units sold, amount column, and the cost per unit column. Okay, next, now see what I'm going to do. ये जो equation मैंने लिखा है C plus P equal to S और उसके बाद direct cost and indirect cost, this is what I'm going to write in my statement. Okay, so I'll first start with obviously. I have to record what cost. पहला which cost it is? Direct cost. I will start here first with direct cost. Write it along with me. Direct cost. Okay. So direct cost mein, which is the first cost? Direct material. Okay, so now I will record direct material. Start with first direct material. Also known as raw material consumed. Okay. Yeah. Now, what did I tell you? What is a direct cost, which is variable and which has to, you know, depend on units produced. What is direct material? Expenses paid for getting the raw material, for purchase of raw material. Right. So this is the manufacturing account debit side. Compare it with financial accounting. Now see the formula. It says opening stock of raw material add purchase of raw material. Okay, so this is all what manufacturing account debits and expenses in connection raw material. Okay, now what is the meaning of this? Expenses in connection to raw material. It means for getting your raw material, whatever expenses you do, okay, at the time of purchase of raw material, whatever expenses you do to get the raw material till your factory, that is called as expenses in connection to raw material. Say for example, आपने रॉ मटेरियल मंगाया चर्च गेट से, ओके, रॉ मटेरियल यू गॉट फ्रॉम चर्च गेट, योर फैक्ट्री इज इन मलार, तो फ्रॉम चर्च गेट टू मलार हाउ विल योर रॉ मटेरियल कम, ऑब्वियसली थ्रू ट्रांसपोर्टेशन, ओके, सो in between if there is a check post, in between if there is a check post which comes and you pay for that check post, then it will increase the price of your raw material. Okay, say your raw material is for 500 rupees, right? Supplier said 500 rupees for raw material. Check post pay you paid 100 rupees, so it will become 500 plus 100, 600. Are you understanding? So similarly, if you are getting your raw material through a shipment, okay, then if you are paying the dock charges, you are paying the import charges, that will also increase the cost of your raw material. So raw material ka kharcha jo aap factory tak lane ke liye karte ho, that is called as expense in connection to raw material. And remember, it should be at the time of purchasing. Okay, so which type of expenses will come here? I'm giving you a note of it. It is carriage and work. Carriage inward is also known as freight inward. Okay, your custom duty, octroi duty, import duty, dock charges, excise duty, okay. If you have insured your raw material, okay, all such expenses, okay, we have paid raw material the cost for Bhai, it increases the cost. Okay, and if you don't incur these expenses, obviously you will not get your raw material till your factory. So any expenses which is done in connection to purchase of raw material will be added. Okay, and if you remember, all these items in financial accounting come under manufacturing. Okay, next, less purchase return. Purchase return of raw material, obviously. Okay, anything which is subtracted, I'll put it in bracket. Okay. Next, less sale of raw materials plan. Okay, manufacturing account credit side. And less closing stock of raw material. Okay, so take it in the round. Okay, so ye jo aapka answer hai, this is called as raw material consumed. Okay. Dear everyone, any doubts to hear, acknowledge it in the chat box if it is clear to everyone. Then I'll move further with the other cost. Okay, fine. Great. Next. Direct cost may next is direct labor. So let us come to direct labor. Okay, so if you remember that diagram which I have explained, you will remember the cost sheet. So aapko ratta marne ki zarurat nahi padegi, just remember the flow, in the flow which I had taught. Okay, you will not have to mug it up. Okay, next, direct labor. Also known as direct wages. Also known as productive wages. And sometimes they give you, there are three categories of labor: skill, I mean direct labor, skill, semi-skill, and unskilled. Okay. Next. Next direct cost is direct expenses. So next, write down direct expenses. It's a lengthy list. Next one to direct expenses. They're also known as chargeable expenses. Okay. Now, while discussing about direct expenses, I had given an example of this one, Mercedes-Benz logo example I have given, right? That was example of royalty on production. Okay, so right here, which items will come under this? So yeah, royalty on production. Next, cost of molds, or you first take down dies, DYES, cost of molds, and higher charges for special equipments. You can even include your direct power. during some, I'll discuss with you. Okay. Power is actually an indirect cost, electricity. So if power is there, I will put it under factory overheads. Indirect cost under factory because it is used for the time of production. If they mention in the question direct power, that means it is directly connected to, okay? I mean, the indication of direct power indicates it's a direct cost, okay? And it is cannot be characterized as direct material, direct labor. So it is categorized under direct expenses, okay? Don't forget about this. So what are these cost of dies, cost of molds, okay? Now, why are they direct cost? Let me first come to that. I'll explain it. So royalty on production, I had explained last lecture. Okay, what is return after sale of raw material? Okay, Devanshi. Sale of raw material. Sale of, it is a raw material scrap. Okay, sale of raw material scrap. And it is less closing stock of raw material. Yeah, and then in the outer column, you will get your direct material consumed. Okay, is it clear? Okay, fine. So, next. Now, let me explain you. What is this cost of dies and what is this cost of molds and what is this higher charges for special equipments? Well, do on production to a high explain, but these three part is left. Okay, now just see, I'll give an example. Okay. I'm a manufacturer of soap. Okay, what is my finished goods? Soap. So I manufacture soap in three different shapes. Okay, say first it is a, what do you call it? Oval shape. Okay, next. Rectangular shape. Next, any other shape? Say round. Okay. So now what is happening? I need to manufacture. What is my basic finished goods? Soap is my basic finished goods. Mera finished goods hai. Ab main usko teen variety mein bechti hu. एक ओवल शेप, एक रेक्टेंगुलर शेप और एक राउंड शेप. ओके, तो इसके लिए मुझे क्या लगेगा? इसके लिए मुझे लगेगा मोल्ड्स. इसको बोलते हैं मोल्ड्स. मोल्ड्स मतलब इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स और इक्विपमेंट्स विच गिव शेप टू द प्रोडक्ट. ओके, इज दैट क्लियर? जैसे ड्यूरिंग दिवाली योर मॉम मस्ट बी मेकिंग करंजीज. So for making karanjis, you require that sacha, karanji ka sacha. So that sacha is called as molds in English. Okay. So to give the soap a oval shape, a rectangular shape, or a round shape, what are you doing? You have to purchase the mold. Okay. So the cost of those three molds will be a direct cost. I'll tell you why. Why also it? I'll tell you. Okay. Next. Abhi suppose mera ye jo oval wala soap hai, ye se pink color ka hai. मेरा रेक्टेंगुलर सोप ग्रीन कलर का है और मेरा राउंड वाला सोप से रेड कलर का है, समझा? तो ये कलर यूज करने के लिए, ओके, व्हाट डू आई नीड? आई नीड डाइज. डाइज आर व्हाट? कलरिंग एजेंट्स. ओके, द कॉस्ट ऑफ डाइज विल कम अंडर दिस कैटेगरी. नाउ यू विल से, मैम व्हाई इट इज अ डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट? ओके, इफ यू रिमेंबर द डेफिनेशन ऑफ कॉस्ट, सो रॉ मटीरियल कन्वर्टिंग इन टू फिनिश गुड्स बोला था मैंने, याद है? सो हमने इधर एक कैस वन ने इसका डेफिनेशन दिया था कन्वर्जन का. कन्वर्जन में क्या क्या आता है? कन्वर्जन में मैंने आप लोग को बताया था द साइज शुड चेंज, द शेप शुड चेंज ऑफ द रॉ मटीरियल, द कलर, फ्रेगनेंस द स्मेल एंड ऑल दैट याद आया. हाँ तो अपने वॉट इज द एग्जाम्पल वी हैव शेप वाला तो कॉस्ट ऑफ मोल्स. वॉट इज द एग्जाम्पल नेक्स्ट आई टू कॉस्ट ऑफ डाइज तो कलर हैज चेंज. ओके सो इट्स अ डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट बराबर. ओके तो डेफिनेशन में ये भी इंक्लूसिव भी है. ओके सो शेप mold is not a raw material, it is not a labor, so it has to be categorized somewhere, but it is a direct cost, it is categorized under direct expense. Same goes for color, cost of dyes, it is not a raw material, it is not a labor, so it has to be categorized somewhere. So as per Casper, it should be categorized under direct expenses. Am I clear about this? Acknowledge it in the chat box if this is clear. Okay. I just don't want, 5-6 students acknowledging. Yeah, others wake up from sleep if you're sleeping. Okay, acknowledge it in the chat box till here it is clear. Because if you don't understand what is direct and indirect cost, you won't be able to do sums at all. Okay, to do sums, you need to have clarity about direct and indirect cost. ओके जब तुमको ये ही नहीं समझेगा कि ये एक्सपेंस डायरेक्ट है या इनडायरेक्ट है तो तुम और आगे का क्लासिफिकेशन कैसे करोगे. क्योंकि वंस यू आइडेंटिफाई इट्स अ डायरेक्ट और इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट उसके बाद भी तो आपको आइडेंटिफाई करना है कि वेदर इट इज अ डायरेक्ट मटीरियल डायरेक्ट लेबर और डायरेक्ट एक्सपेंस. ओके एंड वंस यू आइडेंटिफाई इट्स अ इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट यू हैव टू फर्दर आइडेंटिफाई इट वेदर इट इज फैक्ट्री रिलेटेड ऑफिस रिलेटेड और सेलिंग एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन रिलेटेड. सो मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इज यू शुड नो वेदर द कॉस्ट इज अ डायरेक्ट और इनडायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. So for that, you should remember the definition which I had said, okay? Because that applicability is very important here. Okay? So, these two examples ho gaye, okay? Ab ek example mujhe kiska lena hai? I have to take example of hire equipments, right? Yeah. Hire charges for special equipments. Ab ye kya hota hai? Okay? And don't forget, ये मत भूलना conversion, okay? ये वाला part, don't forget this conversion वाला part, okay? Size, shape, color, fragrance, structure, okay? ये सब change होता है. Now, say for example, again, I have a finished goods, okay? My raw material. I will convert it into finished goods. बराबर. तो ये जो बीच का प्रोसेस है ये बीच वाला ये जो स्टेज है ये जो मैंने एरो लिखा है ये कौन सा स्टेज है. ये WIP स्टेज है. ओके इट इज विच स्टेज. इट इज WIP स्टेज. Everybody agrees to this? Okay. तो जब गुड्स WIP में रहता है मतलब वो तभी मशीन में रहता है. तो से सपोज मेरा रॉ मटेरियल फोर मशीन से जाके फिर फिनिश गुड्स बनता है. मतलब आई नीड फोर मशीन उसके मतलब फर्स्ट रॉ मटेरियल आई पुट इन मशीन वन मशीन टू मशीन थ्री एंड मशीन फोर. ओके सो इट रिक्वायर्स फोर प्रोसेसिंग फोर टाइम्स प्रोसेसिंग इट रिक्वायर्स एंड तब जाके मेरा फिनिश गुड्स बनता है. ओके सो अब क्या होगा मेरे पास I have this machine, I have the second machine, I don't have the third machine, but I have the fourth machine. Are you understanding what combination I get? I have the first machine, second machine and the fourth machine, but third machine mere paas nahi hai. To ye beech ka process mere factory mein nahi hota. Samajh mein aa raha hai what I am saying? Machine 1, machine 2, machine 4 ka processing mere factory mein hota hai. But machine 3 mere paas nahi hai. तो ये प्रोसेसिंग मेरे फैक्ट्री में नहीं होता है. बट अगर ये प्रोसेस नहीं किया तो आगे का स्टेप कंप्लीट नहीं होगा. तो मुझे कुछ तो करना पड़ेगा. तो व्हाट विल आई डू. आई विल आउटसोर्स इट. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय आउटसोर्सिंग. आई विल गिव इट टू सम अदर मैन्युफैक्चरर हु हैज दिस मशीन. ओके सो डू यू थिंक ही इज गोइंग टू डू माई वर्क फॉर फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट. ऑब्वियसली नॉट. ही विल चार्ज सर्टेन अमाउंट टू मी एंड दैट इज नोन एज हायर चार्जेस. Hire, what do you mean by the word hire? Hire means rent, bhada. Okay, hire means rent. तो हायर चार्जेस फॉर स्पेशल इक्विपमेंट्स इसको बोलते हैं. ओके, हायर चार्जेस फॉर स्पेशल इक्विपमेंट्स. ओके, और कैस फाइव में, कैस वन में स्पेशल इक्विपमेंट्स का भी डेफिनेशन है. ओके, अभी आप बोलोगे मैम ये जो है मशीन वन, मशीन टू, ये मशीन थ्री, ओके दिस इज इक्विपमेंट्स, दीज आर प्लांट एंड मशीनरी बिकॉज इट इज योर्स, तुम्हारा है. ठीक है, लेकिन ये जो थर्ड वन है ये तुम्हारा नहीं है, ये तुमने किसी से भाड़े पे लिया है. तो ये मशीन थ्री तुम्हारे लिए स्पेशल इक्विपमेंट है. अंडरस्टैंडिंग वॉट एवर आई एम सेइंग? ओके, मशीन विच इज नॉट ओन्ड बाई यू बट यू हैव टेकन इट, यू हैव आउटसोर्स इट फ्रॉम समवन सो दैट योर प्रोडक्शन एक्टिविटी इज स्मूथ, इट डजंट स्टॉप, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज स्पेशल इक्विपमेंट. ओके, सो ऑब्वियसली इट्स अ डायरेक्ट कॉल. जब तक तुम ये भाड़ा नहीं दोगे स्पेशल इक्विपमेंट्स के लिए तो कैस वन का ये डेफिनेशन चेंज नहीं होगा ना, ये शेप वाला, फॉर्म वाला, स्ट्रक्चर वाला. ओके, सो फॉर चेंजिंग द शेप, द फॉर्म, द स्ट्रक्चर. ओके, जैसे हो सकता है आपका ये रॉ मटेरियल लिक्विड हो, आपने इसको फोर मशीन्स में डालने के बाद आपका जो फिनिश गुड्स है वो सॉलिड हो गया हो. व्हाट इज हैपनिंग, द फॉर्म इज चेंजिंग फ्रॉम लिक्विड फॉर्म, इट इज कमिंग टू द सॉलिड फॉर्म. ओके, सो फॉर्म इज चेंजिंग सो इट इज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग टू दिस फॉर्म, आई मीन टू द डेफिनेशन. ओके, सो इट्स अ डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. एम आई क्लियर टू यू? या स्टार्ट गिविंग योर अटेंडेंस ऑल्सो, पोस्टेड इन द चैट बॉक्स, एंड दिस पॉइंट इज क्लियर, एक्नॉलेज दैट ऑल्सो. क्लियर, इट्स क्लियर नाउ? ओके, फाइन. ओके, एंड साइमल्टेनियसली लिखते भी जाओ. अब हम इसका टोटल करेंगे. ओके, सो डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट. हेलो, प्राइम कॉस्ट. ओके, प्राइम कॉस्ट हाउ विल यू गेट? 1 + 2 + 3, मतलब डायरेक्ट मटेरियल प्लस डायरेक्ट लेबर प्लस डायरेक्ट एक्सपेंसेस इज इक्वल टू प्राइम कॉस्ट. सी, डायरेक्ट मटेरियल, डायरेक्ट लेबर, डायरेक्ट एक्सपेंसेस, ओके, इक्वल टू प्राइम कॉस्ट. Okay, clear. So till here it's clear to everyone. Okay, so I'll move on to the next part. Okay. Obviously, it will take two lectures to complete the format because the format is lengthy and I want to go slow with the format so that I can go fast with the sums. So if I go slow with the format, so we will be fast with the sums. Okay. So next, what is next? देखो, ये formula, right? अपना ये हो गया. This is done. Correct. Now we'll come to indirect cost. और indirect cost में पहला क्या है? Factory overheads. So start. Okay. Next, add the second part, that is indirect cost. This first factory overheads. also known as manufacturing overheads, also known as production overheads, also known as works overheads. We still have last 2 minutes, so kindly acknowledge in the chat box expenses in connection to factory overheads. Okay, write it in the chat box. Write in your chat box. I want different examples of factory overheads. We had discussed it in last lecture. Okay, good. Fuel power, yes. Factory rent, yes. Factory insurance, anyone? Thank you. Simulator is name writing here. Fuel, factory rent. Okay. Yeah, fuel or power. Yeah. Next, factory insurance. Okay. Next. Okay, water supply. Anything else? Labor charges, okay, but the indirect one, okay, indirect labor, not direct. Okay, factory equipments nahi bacha, that's an asset. Depreciation on factory equipments, repairs and maintenance of factory equipments, that will come.